Welcome to the Solstice Global Forgiveness Meditation. This meditation is happening in many countries, in many cities around the world, as you join in with your prayers for the next 20 minutes as we practice forgiveness, which is the greatest act of power that a shaman can make. Forgiveness does not mean that you have done anything to anyone or anyone has done anything to you that needs to be forgiven. Forgiveness is the practice of coming into a state of aini, of right relationship, into a state that we call in the West grace. So I invite you to light a candle, to take a few deep breaths, to join us in the Andes during the solstice, during the time that the sun is closest to the earth and farthest away from the earth, depending on which hemisphere you're at. And to take a few deep breaths, to drop into your breath, to create your sacred space, your environment of peace around yourself. And I'd like you to begin by connecting to the trees and to the waterfalls and to the rivers in the land around you. Even if you are in a big city, reach out and connect to the great trees. Call in the spirits of the rivers to come and be present. Call in on the Pachamama, on Mother Earth, to come and join us in this celebration of prayer. Forgiveness is the act of coming back into right relationship with yourself, with your history, with your destiny, and with all of nature. As we sit in prayer in the Andes, preparing a despacho, preparing an offering with our prayers that we will give to the earth, to the Pachamama, to bring us into right relationship with her. At this time, when there's such a great need to be in right relationship with each other and with Mother Earth. Take a few deep breaths, gentle, slow breaths. And call on the spirits of nature to come and bear witness to this act of power that we're going to be making together around the world. Call on your ancestors and those that have departed and those that are still present today. Call on your children, on your children's children, those that have not yet been born, to come and bear witness to this act of power that we make globally and individually. And I'd like you to begin with a journey, to close your eyes and to begin going backwards along your timeline to the last few days, the last few weeks, the last few months, the last few years, further and further back until you come to the time that you were inside your mother's womb. And even before that, to the moment of your conception, and take yourself to that moment of your conception where you are in this bubble of light, a spirit about to be born, to be conceived into the world. And I'd like you to see yourself enveloped in a bubble of light, a luminous bubble. And I'd like you to take yourself back to that moment when you were conceived, when the sperm and the egg join in this miraculous moment, when you, who are a drop of infinity, determined that you were going to be born in this earth, in this planet, to fulfill a mission. And with your eyes closed, continuing to breathe deeply, I'd like you to recall what that mission was. What did you come here to do? What was your calling? Why were you born into the parents that you were born into? And I'd like you to practice gratitude towards them, to thank them for this beautiful moment of union that allowed you to be born. To know that you were drawn to these parents, to to learn certain lessons, that you selected them. And I'd like you to practice grace and forgiveness towards them, deep gratitude for allowing you to be born in this planet. And I'd like you to go even further back to your mother's conception, to your father's conception, and even further back to your grandparents' conception, and even further back to the first time that life was conceived on this earth. And I'd like you to have a sense, an understanding of what mission, of what purpose Spirit chose for life to be born in this beautiful blue-green planet. And to allow that sense of purpose and understanding to permeate every cell in your being. Thank you. As we practice forgiveness together, we're joining thousands of men and women around the planet who are holding a beacon of meaning, of celebration, and of grace at this very moment. And to connect with all of the men and women that are joining us in this celebration, and to see ourselves as nodes in a great net that is enveloping the entire planet. A network and a net of celebration and forgiveness. That as the earth and the sun come into perfect balance and alignment on this day, which is the shortest day and the longest day, the shortest night and the longest night of the year. That as we practice forgiveness and grace, that we come into right relationship with the earth, that we allow ourselves to be carried by a river of beauty and of grace and of wisdom that continually flows around us, and to surrender to this flow, to stop fighting this flow, to allow this flow of grace and beauty to permeate your existence, your being, every cell in your body, to surrender to this flow of grace, of celebration, and of beauty, no matter how difficult your circumstances may seem, no matter how harsh your existence may seem in this earth, to know that that is only a perception, that even within great difficulty, we can practice beauty and we can practice grace. To know that that is the act of power that the person of knowledge makes, that the only true act of power that we can make is to practice beauty and grace, no matter what our circumstances might seem like. And experience yourself awash in this river of beauty and of grace and of joy. And as you join the shamans of the Andes, the shamans of Africa, the shamans of Australia, the shamans of Europe, the shamans of Asia, the shamans of Russia, as you join them in this moment of celebration, to know that we are held and carried and supported by our Mother, the Earth. To know that we're held and carried and supported by the prayers of the men and women that are joining us in this meditation. To know that we're held and carried and supported by each other. And to know that as we choose to celebrate instead of to grieve, that as we choose grace instead of pain, that we're making an extraordinary act of power that will resonate throughout our lives, that will carry you throughout the rest of the year, that will set you in a course of destiny that is unchangeable as you are true to your mission and your purpose, as you recall with clarity the reason that you came here, what you came here to do, what gifts you came to share, what lessons you came to learn, what experiences you came to have, and to remember that it is through experience that we blossom into our capabilities, that we blossom into full humans, that we blossom into the fullest expression of grace, of beauty, and of power. As we come to a close to our meditation, remember that this moment continues. As we put out our fires, our candles, remember that this fire continues burning, that this light will continue to illumine you, to illuminate all of your actions. As we come to a close of this meditation, remember that the understanding and the wisdom of your meaning, your purpose, and your mission remain deeply engraved in your consciousness, guiding every one of your actions as you choose to practice peace, to practice beauty, to practice grace, and to practice joy forever.